everybody.
Hello, Pulse fans. Hello, Star Wars fans. Hello, you know, just fans of live streams out there. Maybe you
Welcome.
Just love, I know, maybe you just love live streams. Maybe you're just like clicking around. You were on a cooking live stream. I don't know. Apparently, I think that, you know, the internet is like TV and you just click around like from one live stream to the next. You're watching.
And now you're here at the best live stream.
The best one of all. Yeah, you were on, I don't know, like Martha Stewart's live stream. And now here you find yourself on the Star Wars Hasbro toy live stream. So, but we're happy to have you. It's like family here. You know, everyone's welcome. You know, call your mom, tell her to come on down. We take all comers. We love everyone. Emily, how are you doing?
I'm doing great, Patrick.
It's amazing. You having a good Friday so far? Good Friday morning?
Every day is a good day when you design Star Wars toys.
I know. You get to talk about Star Wars toys. People can't believe we do this for a living, but it's amazing. it's great to be here. We're a little earlier here on Friday than normal. It's just because we just couldn't wait. They were like, no, you have to wait till 11 o'clock. That's the normal time. We were like, no, we just got to make this happen 10 a.m. We just can't wait. We got to get going. But we are so excited. Obviously, you know, we're not going to run through the drill. You guys, you viewers, fans out there, you are seasoned Pulse live stream pros at this point. You know, obviously, we kicked this off, you know, when was it? May. It was only May. It was only 3 months ago. I don't know how many live streams Pulse has done at this point. It's been a lot. But you guys are pros. You've viewed a lot. So we are going to dive in and start talking about what we're going to talk about. So this is when, what day is it? This is August 21st. So this is around when Celebration was going to happen. So this isn't replacing Celebration, but we kind of just wanted to do a live stream around this point in time just to kind of mark this moment in time and celebrate when Celebration was going to happen. So it's been a great past month or so, great past 4 weeks. We've had some amazing reveals. Our, you know, wonderful kind of exclusive items that we were going to do for SDCC. We had those Walmart amazing Clone Wars items, the Target items. And the fun is going to continue here. We're going to have some great product reveals, some reveals of new programs, other great news. The show, this is going to have something for everyone. Like we said, we take all comers. It's going to have, you know, some Black Series reveals. It's going to have a premium roleplay reveal. More Pulse content, and then also,
and like the last show, we're going to bring a focus on our 3¾-inch scaled world. So, guys, we continue to hear and just really appreciate your support for the vintage collection. We'd love to hear it. So, we'll have a few vintage collection reveals today. We'll have some more details about our HasLab campaign at the end, though we're not quite revealing what it is yet, sorry. And though it's not TVC, we'll have some more news from the 3¾-inch world to share. And so, like our last live stream, we're going to kick things off with all of our 3¾-inch items up front, starting with our vintage collection reveals.
Absolutely. And again, that HasLab news, again, we're not revealing what it is, so don't get too excited. It's a small piece of news, but it is at the end, so stick with us. And let's dive in with the vintage collection. Now, just in case, we're seeing that wonderful logo, so classic. Just in case, for any newer viewers of the live stream who might not be aware, the vintage collection is our 3¾-inch fan-focused line. It's the original scale of Star Wars figures. Obviously, we love it. It's super articulated, a high level of deco and detail. Now, one of our biggest, literally, reveals in years was a month ago. About with the reveal of the Millennium Falcon, inspired by the starship, the vehicle seen at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge at Disneyland Resort and Walt Disney World Resort. And we actually have a video that we'd like to show right now.
I suggest a new strategy, R2. Let the Wookiee win.
R5, pre-flight diagnostics report. Things are getting too hot. We've got to get out of here.
Great. So obviously, it was wonderful to bring that item back. You know, obviously, that was a classic item in the line. We saw the demand from fans. We saw that aftermarket value. And Star Wars Galaxy's Edge just gave us a great opportunity to deliver both that version inspired by the original trilogy and also the newer version inspired by Galaxy's Edge. It comes with that swappable radar dish, lights, sounds, other features. And it was also great to see the vehicle include characters that came along for the ride. Chewbacca, Porgs, and that fan favorite Hondo Onaka, that, you know, great space pirate. You know, but as we go through that list, you know, Chewbacca, great, love him. Porgs, you know, wonderful from Last Jedi, and Hondo. One of those, you know, hasn't been in the mainline vintage collection yet. It belongs in the mainline, definitely deserves to be in the mainline. Bringing us to our first reveal of the day, it is Hondo Onaka on a vintage card back for the first time. You can see him in beautiful form on your screen right there. Now, when we first, and you can see him right here, I've got the physical version here on a card back. Now, when we first released the Hondo Onaka figure, we originally based the design on concept art. After the character was revealed at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge for the vintage collection, we were able to go back and do the figure justice in terms of the live-action debut of the character at the parts. As you can see, it's a beautiful representation of the character with a soft PVC outer jacket and the secondary layered goggles to allow them to be transparent on the face. You can see the packaging here on the screen as well in a second. It's a brand new pill color to the vintage collection. It was actually selected specifically for Star Wars Galaxy's Edge inspired product to match the color on the Star Wars Galaxy's Edge inspired Falcon box. The color is actually from the deco on the Star Wars Galaxy's Edge buildings. It's actually the first time in recent memory that we've introduced a new color. The film out is based on the composite images from Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. So it's a really great new addition to the line, and we're pleased it's our first reveal of the day. It's available for pre-order today at 4 p.m. on Pulse and at most major retailers, and it's on shelf later this fall. Alrighty, the next thing we want to talk about is Rogue One. We want to talk about Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. Now, all of the new entertainment movies are great, but this one is honestly one of our favorites. As we've talked with fans at conventions on elsewhere we've seen online, we think that it's not too early to do a small mini beat for the fifth anniversary of Rogue One, because 2021 is, of course, that fifth anniversary. Now, we'll tell you right now, we're not going to be doing, you know, a mainline assortment with Black Series figures in packaging, hearkening back to the 2016 packaging, doing a commemorative logo, anything like that, that we did this year for the 40th anniversary of Empire Strikes Back. But we will be doing a mini beat on sprinkling in some Rogue One throughout the line, starting with our next reveal. Ties in, as you'll see, a little bit to Rogue One. So we're very excited about that. So on to the reveal. Now, we've mentioned that one of the things we love about the vintage collection is that it's an awesome scale for expansive world building. You know, I've certainly said that one of the things I love most about the vintage collection is that ability to build out. And playsets allow us a way to do that. So we're excited that to announce our next playset just a couple of months after we announced our Bespin Carbon Freezing Chamber playset. Now, like I said, it ties into Rogue One. It won't actually come in Rogue One packaging, but it was inspired by our love from Rogue One. You'll get it. You'll see how this all ties together. And it does contain an item inside that does come on Rogue One packaging. We're laying the breadcrumbs. So, Emily, tell us more.
So, if you're putting the pieces together, you might catch that our next reveal is the Tantive IV playset.
Amazing. I think this wins the award for the most amazing, like, on-screen, like, physical product. I don't know how you're holding all that up.
And here it is. All right. So this one is so cool, guys. So basically, we've got some incredible label artwork, bringing those panels on the back wall sort of to life. We treated this with a semi-gloss finish, so you're going to get some nice reflections in the floor in your photography. And we've got manually functioning doors sliding just like they did in the content. Right there. So I think it's going to be just a super fun one to take photography of and one that we're really passionate about.
Fantastic.
All right, guys. So the Tantive IV, it's one of the first opening shots of New Hope. It's an incredible process. And we also love the way that the Tantive IV creates this story bridge between the stories of A New Hope. And we know that the iconic Darth Vader hallway scene in Rogue One, it wasn't technically on the Tantive IV. It was on Admiral Raddus's Star Cruiser. And just after that, the Rebel fleet sort of narrowly escapes to the Tantive with the Death Star plans. But we still love the link of the Tantive IV between those two stories. And really, both films inspired us to create this playset scene. So as we've said, we've been excited to return to playsets as a way to build out the vintage world. This Tantive IV playset, it's going to continue with our modular approach, like we've done with previous playsets. So you can buy multiple and build it out. And we built this as one of our most modular and flexible environment sets yet. So you're just going to be able to continue to build out those corridors as you'd like. And as a little treat, here's something we've set up for you. This is two playsets assembled together with additional purchase figures to create just an incredible battle scene. And if you can see in there, some of these troopers are seriously in danger. So we just think you're going to be able to create some incredible stuff with this.
I love the difference when a marketer reveals a playset on our live stream a couple months ago. You can see up here. I just held up the packaging. When the designer reveals the playset, she builds out all the modular playsets. So kudos to you, Emily.
Yeah, I have my coffee this morning, just setting that all up.
That's awesome. That looked amazing.
Yeah, it's definitely fun. All right, guys. So, and just as a reminder, that one was two playsets and just multiple separately purchased figures. So basically, you can continue to build that out to your heart's delight with what you've got. So this set also, I wanted to mention, this offers both that main Tantive hallway and it's got the rear corridor. So that's for that scene where Leia puts the Death Star plans into R2-D2. It's that great, you're my only hope scene. Just like that, such a cool hallway. And that one particularly is also two sets together. And so with our past playsets, the Tantive IV, it does come with a figure exclusive to the playset. And this is going to be a Rebel Fleet Trooper on a Rogue One card back for the first time.
Awesome.
And he comes with photoreal deco for the first time for this character. His accessories are going to give you different configurations for how to gear the character up for different looks and just kind of build out a differentiated fleet of troopers with your multiple sets. And now this one's a special figure with a different entertainment source from the entertainment source of the playset, which is kind of a new configuration for us. But this set blends the lines between those two entertainment scenes. And so we thought it would be a treat just to get you this figure on a new card back for you, just for something fresh. And we will reveal that card back at a later date.
Absolutely. That's good. So cool. Now, obviously, again, on our last live stream, we revealed that Bespin Carbon Freezing Chamber playset. And similarly, when we revealed that playset, we were missing a key figure for that playset, the Bespin Escape Leia. So we took that opportunity to add her to the line, and we revealed her along with the playset on that live stream. Now, the Tantive IV playset is similar in that there's a key figure who needs a modern update and that we would love to see on a Rogue One card back, because that character, he or she, we'll see in a second, plays such a cool role in that film, which brings us to our next vintage collection reveal. Who could it be? It is Darth Vader, who I have here, and you'll see on your screen, he's going to be on a Rogue One card back for the first time. So this choice was all about being able to modernize Vader for the vintage collection in a way that takes advantage of the progressions that we've made. He builds on that existing F4 Vader figure with a newly sculpted torso and an updated helmet, lightsaber, and robe. Now, these pieces are more accurate to the on-screen costume details than they've been in past releases. We brought the best deco learnings from other expressions you can see right here to make it more accurate than the previous Vaders in the vintage collection. For example, if you can see, I'll hold it up here, the patterns on his helmet more closely match the Rogue One look. And for the first time, as you'll be able to see, we were able to depict Vader on a new, never-before-seen card back. So obviously, all you vintage fans know that Vader has only previously been in the vintage collection on that original card back that covered F4, F5, and F6. Despite having differentiation in the figures, the card back was always the same since we stayed true to the original products. But since this was a Rogue One Vader, we're able to depict him for the first time in a new cardback representation, which is just so exciting. Like, for the first time in the vintage collection, that new representation. As you can see, it's that iconic scene from Rogue One, which you're seeing right here, which is fantastic. And now the release details for those two items. Both are available for pre-order today at 4 p.m. on Pulse and at most major retailers. And both will be on shelf early spring 2021, which is the end of our vintage collection reveals, which is so exciting. But more news in the 3 3/4 inch world.
All right, guys. So it's a time of change for Star Wars. The Skywalker saga has concluded, and we're so excited to honor that saga. And it's a time of change for toys as well. So through our kid testing, we found that kids are looking for more features in their action figure play. So our kid-focused action figure line for The Rise of Skywalker introduced the Galaxy of Adventures line with action features, which is continuing with more new figures to come. You may have noticed that 2019 was our first year without a kid-focused 5-point articulated 3 3/4 inch line. And for the future, we'll be focusing on highly articulated 3 3/4 inch figures and our newer kid expressions. So today, we're celebrating the saga with a template that started it all. 5-point articulated 3 3/4 inch figures, available for a limited time and in limited quantities before they get placed into the vault. So we wanted to throw a party for this line with our Celebrate the Saga program. And this is going to consist of 8 packs with all of the best 5-point articulated 3 3/4 inch figures from our kid line over the past years, arranged by factions and available for a limited time. And when they're gone, we are putting our kid-focused 5-point articulated 3 3/4 inch line into the vault. And that doesn't mean we're never going to do them again. It just means that for now, they're in the vault. And to confirm, this does not include retro. That's fan-focused in a different styling. And we love it. Watch out for more of it. But Celebrate the Saga, it includes the kid-focused lines of the past several years. So let's take a look at the first of these eight new packs. And if you're talking about factions of the Star Wars universe and you're talking about celebrating the Skywalker saga, there's one faction and one character you just have to start with. And so this is our first reveal, the Rebel Alliance pack. And here it is. Some great heroes and some amazing new packaging look. I think our team did an amazing job setting up some of this back photography.
Wow.
So these packs are about being able to separate out some of the most significant crews that the saga was able to bring to the Star Wars galaxy. And we group these characters together by their faction, not just their entertainment. So with this pack, we want to highlight the best of the Rebel Alliance. You'll also notice that the figures in this line are each receiving a photoreal face update, which is just a really nice upgrade from their previous releases. And we designed a brand new packaging look for this expression to send off our 5-point articulated line in style. For Celebrate the Saga, we created a unique logo, as well as a custom line look for each of the packs. And as you can see, this Rebel Alliance pack is coated blue for the light side. The back panel of each of these items is going to have this amazing group shot of the figures featured in each pack. Basically, we created like a custom set for our photo shoots that had repeatable, nondescript Star Wars tech feel without being too specific, since we just had so many figures and groups from the different movies and different timelines. And then our team brought in like these blue lighting gels that were used to set the tone for these figures and just cast some really cool lighting. We shot with a low camera angle for that heroic look, and we added in like some canned fog for atmosphere, and it all just came together for these amazing shots. So this Rebel Alliance pack will be available for pre-order today at 4 p.m. on Amazon and on shelf later this fall.
Wow. And Emily, I just want to make sure I'm clear. If I'm a fan of this, kind of kid-focused line, but 5 POA, 3 3/4 inch, not including retro, these are going in the vault, so this is my last chance to get them?
Yeah, you better get on it, Patrick.
Oh, all right. I will act fast. All righty. Now, of course, in terms of factions within Star Wars, there's obviously the Rebel Alliance. But then, in terms of modern-day Star Wars, our modern-day equivalent is, of course, the Resistance. That's right. You can see it here. We also love kind of the reflection here. You might be able to see Emily in the screen. But obviously, you can see here the Resistance pack is the best of the heroes from the Resistance and the sequel trilogy. And you can see the glamour shots on the screen here. This obviously brought Star Wars to a new generation of kids and fans in the modern day. We love them all. You're seeing the product there. It's great. And a look at the packaging that kind of brings it all together in that way that Emily said. It's also available for pre-order today at 4 p.m. on Amazon. It's an Amazon exclusive and also on shelf later this fall.
Now, as we think about factions within the Skywalker saga and the Rebel being sort of the successors of the Rebel Alliance, but that's not always the case. Some factions are opposed to each other. And so that leads us to our next pack, the faction opposed to the Resistance. That's right. It's the First Order.
Nice.
So it's important to have troop building packs, as troopers play just such an important role within the galaxy. And this set offers Captain Phasma, General Hux, and variants of First Order troopers. And in addition, we've got those devious little droids seen on the First Order ships. So as you can see, in contrast to the previous two items, our dark side items are coded red for the dark side. And lighting gels in red were used to set this evil tone for the photography of these figures. Available for pre-order today at 4 p.m. on Pulse and most major retailers, and on shelf later this fall.
All right. Now, one of the best things about Star Wars, one of the things I love the most, is the droids. I'm sure kind of fans out there, you love that as well. And we made sure, as you've seen in the first three so far, that each of these packs contained a droid, as they're an integral part of many of these factions. Now, my favorite things about these Celebrate the Saga packs is that the next five actually have a droid making their character debut or reappearance in the 3¾-inch scale. And in terms of a reappearance in a long time. Now, our first three packs were in the original trilogy or sequel trilogy era, but our next pack brings us back to the heroes of the prequel trilogy for the Jedi Order, with R7-A7 in his character debut within the Hasbro collection. That's right. Looks amazing. I know. Hi, R7-A7. Good to meet you. You can see here on the back. He looks wonderful. And he's right there. Cute little guy. Now, this faction highlights the last of the Jedi Order before their fall after the events of Order 66. You're seeing the glamour shots here. Which is why, for you eagle-eyed fans out there, this pack doesn't include Luke and Rey. Now, I'm sure you know R7-A7 is Ahsoka's droid, a unique astromech in terms of colors and personality. Now, again, this is the debut of that character in the realistic styling. He had only existed in the past in the Clone Wars animated styling. So we're excited to bring him to this pack. Again, as with the others, it's available for pre-order today at 4 p.m. on Pulse and at most major retailers. And again, it's on shelf later this fall. So that's our next pack.
And so the Jedi Order consisted of the generals of the Republic Army. Now, generals are going to need troops, and fans are going to need troops to army build, which brings us to the Galactic Republic. And with OOM-10, the battle droid, in his character debut. So here's our Galactic Republic set.
Nice.
I always think troopers all up in a row look the coolest.
Yeah.
So this one's a cool pack, guys. The Galactic Army gave us really cool clone forms throughout the prequel trilogy. This pack celebrates those different variants and ranks throughout the Clone Wars. And OOM-10 here, he was captured and reprogrammed by R2-D2 to serve the Republic, kind of like how K2SO served under the Rebel Alliance, which is why he joins this pack. I love his look with the tan and the blue patterning. This is this character's debut anywhere in the Hasbro lines. And so this set is available for pre-order today at 4 p.m. on Pulse and most major retailers, and on shelf later this fall.
Cool.
And as we work through these factions, given the sweep of Star Wars history throughout the entirety of the Skywalker saga, there's lots of different successors and generations, with the Rebel Alliance, for example, leading to the Resistance, while the Republic Army also led to another faction, the Galactic Empire.
I feel like we should have music right here.
So cool in the red. So the Galactic Empire, it's the best of the best for the Empire. This one has R2-Q5 in his character return. R2-Q5 was part of the Power of the Jedi line back in 2001. And this is his first 3¾-inch update since then. They're all just looking so super bad with those red gels. And so this one is available for pre-order today at 4 p.m. on Best Buy and on shelves later this fall.
Fantastic. All righty. Now, many of these factions are tied to a specific era of Star Wars. Obviously, the Republic, the Empire, the First Order, the Rebel Alliance, the Resistance, etc. But as you know, some factions within Star Wars tend to kind of sweep over all of the eras. To be sure, the Jedi Order is one such faction. But as discussed, since most of the Jedi we see are in the prequel trilogy era, we chose to limit it to that era. But that's not necessarily the case for the Bounty Hunters. That's right. These packs are even better when they cover up my face. That makes them even more beneficial. As you can see, we've got R5-P8 in his character debut, looking fantastic. Now, this set was all about being able to have some of the best-known bounty hunters in the galaxy. And as you know, R5-P8 is Hondo Onaka's droid, so we're bringing it full circle back to Hondo at the beginning of the live stream. R5 is a unique R5 unit with that shark mouth drawn on the front and some great weathering. He's a unique form and a less traditional assassin droid, and in the lore, he paved the way for later deadly droids like BT-1. So you're seeing the product there. It's great-looking packaging as well. We love the set. It's available for pre-order today, as with the other ones, at 4 p.m. on Pulse and most major retailers, and also on shelf later this fall.
And finally, if you've been keeping track at home, there's another critical faction that brings passion and power to the Star Wars galaxy. We've got some of the most iconic characters in the saga, and like bounty hunters, it stretches the known history. We're talking, of course, about the Sith, and this one has TC4 in his character debut. So this one's an awesome set, guys. TC4 is going to make his character debut with his cool deep gloss red look. He was Palpatine's personal protocol droid, serving the Imperial Senate, knowing the inner secrets of the Sith. And this set has the best that the Sith has to offer. It spans the trilogies, and we've got a powerful dark side wielders up in here, and we've got the ultra villain with Palpatine. And this one will be available for pre-order today at 4 p.m. on Best Buy and on shelves later this fall. So that's it for our Celebrate the Saga line. Hopefully you're excited to send out our 5POA line in style with us before we put it in the vault. And then we'll continue to focus in on the 3 3/4 inch world with the highly articulated vintage collection and with the retro collection.
Fantastic. So exciting. All righty. Let's keep the live stream moving. So 3 3/4 inch scale is great. As I've mentioned, it's my favorite scale. But we also love our Black Series 6-inch figures. Now, as you know, the Black Series is our other fan-focused expression with 6-inch figures, highly decoed, detail sculpt, and high articulation. Now, Gaming Greats is a new program within the Black Series this year with GameStop to bring some amazing Star Wars video game characters to the Black Series line. We're really excited about this line. It's done wonderful things, and we're excited to start exploring this area of the lore a little bit more. There have been some incredible Star Wars video games over the years, and recently, we've seen more enthusiasm from fans than ever for collectibles and toys inspired by those games. Recent reveals over the past several months include Jedi Knight Revan, Heavy Battle Droid, Stormtrooper Commander, Shadow Stormtrooper, and Jango Fett. And today, we are revealing the next Gaming Greats figure. Now, last fall, we saw the release of Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order from Entertainment Earth, Respawn Entertainment, and Lucasfilm Games. That game was a huge hit with fans, and we're excited to reveal that our next Gaming Greats item comes from that game. It's the Electro Staff Purge Trooper. So exciting. You're seeing it on your screen. It looks amazing. It's such a great item. The deco update for this figure basically details it to be the specialist variation of the original trooper that we did last year in 2019. He has updates, as you're seeing, on the skirt and pauldron colors for his rank, as you saw in the game. And of course, kind of the most significant accessory that you're seeing is a brand new sculpted accessory. He has that Magna staff with a cool electrical effect. Those effect pieces can be removed on and off at each end of the Magna staff. Now, obviously, you'll notice that this is in our old line look. Obviously, Black Series fans out there, you know that we revealed our new line look a couple of months ago, and everyone seemed to love it, which is great. We love hearing that. Basically, we started our Gaming Greats collection in the spring with those first four figures. We didn't want it to be disjointed, So we decided to keep the full year in this line look that you're seeing right here. And then if gaming greats continues in 2021, we'll see. We don't know. We don't comment on anything that's not revealed yet. At that point, then, we would update to the new line look. You're seeing here, it's got kind of this great magenta. The purple in the Electrostaff Trooper was too close to Revan, so we updated the packaging to more of a magenta look. And that also matches the staffel for pre-order today at 4 p.m., of course, at GameStop. And it's on shelf later this fall. And that Gaming Greats program is amazing. So look for more items there to come as well this fall.
All right. So let's shift gears now and talk a little bit about the Clone Wars. So the Clone Wars has been big this year, guys, with the amazing conclusion to Season 7. And then with our Walmart CollectorCon online event, we got more Black Series Season 7 Clone Wars figures into the line, with Ahsoka Tano, the 332nd Clone Trooper, a Mandalorian Loyalist, and the Mandalorian Super Commando. And the fan response to the figures was amazing. So here's a look at those. And we know how much fans love Clone Troopers, so we're always excited to get more into the line. And our next reveal is another clone variant. It's the Clone Trooper Phase 1 Lieutenant, and here he is. We debuted a new Black Series Clone Trooper mold on our May live stream, so this one utilizes that previous mold, and we're really excited about that, as it's going to allow us to get more Clone Troopers into the line at once so that we can build out those troops. He's got typical Phase 1 Clone Trooper armor with that new blue deco patterning for that Lieutenant color scheme. And he's the first character of the Attack of the Clones packaging lineup. So the color of the band is inspired by the movie poster. And he'll be available for pre-order September 15th at Walgreens and on shelf later this fall at Walgreens.
All righty. Shifting gears from Black Series 6-inch figures into premium roleplay. It has been a great year for our premium roleplay segment. We did probably our best and most popular helmet yet with our Boba Fett helmet. And our Protofet helmet, which you can see, maybe not in this screen, but when we go widescreen, our Protofet helmet was a great variant as well. And lightsabers has been fantastic, too. We revolutionized our Force Effects line with Force Effects Elite lightsabers last fall, and we revealed our brand new offering at New York Toy Fair with Darth Revan. It will be shipping here in the coming weeks if it hasn't already, and we actually have a new video to play. So roll clip now.
From Star Wars, the Black Series, the Darth Revan Force Effects Elite Lightsaber. Journey from the dark side to the light with the first ever color-changing Force Effects lightsaber. Featuring removable blades and crafted with a real metal hilt, complete with removable kyber crystal. Harness the legendary power of Revan with dynamic blade effects like progressive ignition, entertainment-inspired sounds, battle clash action, and a molten glow cutting effect. Master both sides of the Force with the Black Series Darth Revan Force Effects Elite Lightsaber.
All right, that Darth Revan Force Effects Elite Lightsaber looks amazing, and today we will be revealing the next in our Force Effects Elite line. Now, we've been doing Force Effects and now Force Effects Elite Lightsabers for many years, and we've built roleplay lightsabers belonging to nearly 20 different characters, including heroes and villains from every era. But there was one central, overarching character that we had never done. And especially after his surprise appearance at Celebration in 2019, we knew we had to get him into the line, so roll film to reveal this item.
From Star Wars, the Black Series presents the Emperor Palpatine Force Effects Elite Lightsaber, the ultimate villain of the Skywalker saga, and the secret weapon that helped him conquer the galaxy, crafted with inspiration from his signature metal hilt. With a removable blade and a Sith Red progressive ignition. Featuring effects like movie-inspired sounds, battle clash action, a molten glow cutting effect, and the all-new dynamic Force Lightning effect. Imagine unlimited power with the Black Series Emperor Palpatine Force Effects Elite Lightsaber. Batteries not included.
Yep, that's right. We are finally doing an Emperor Palpatine Force Effects lightsaber in elite form. Now, we couldn't believe we had never done this, and after his amazing appearance in The Rise of Skywalker, the time was right. Now, it comes packed with all of the standard Force Effects Elite features, and I have a product sample right here. I'm going to try to demonstrate it in the frame. So, obviously, it has premium deco and details. It has movie-inspired lights and sounds. It's got a premium display stand. It's got the real metal hilt, addressable LEDs for that progressive ignition effect. It has removable blades, and so I have a version right here that is hilt-only. So you can cosplay, obviously, at conventions. It has battle clash effects, so you can pretend that you are blocking blaster bolts, and you have those sound effects. It has an effect where you can cosplay. I don't know if you can see this, but that you're cutting through a wall. I don't know if that's reading. And then it has a brand new exclusive force lightning effect, where it basically flashes electric blue for force lightning. And then relatively rare in our Force Effects Elite line and our Force Effects line, this lightsaber features, if you can see it, a fully chrome finish on the hilt for a dazzling visual appearance, inspired by the entertainment. And then also unique to this lightsaber in the Force Effects Elite line, on the neck of the lightsaber, there's actually a separate emitter end for when the blade is attached versus when it's not. It's because this hilt is unique in the Force Effects Elite line and being relatively narrow at the end. So there's basically a separate emitter end needed in both instances to achieve maximum screen accuracy. It basically helps achieve the ideal ignited and unignited emitter for maximum display ability. So that was a lot of information about this item. I love it. It's a great addition to our premium roleplay line. It's available for pre-order today at 4 p.m. on Pulse and most major retailers, and it's on shelf later this fall. Whew, that's a lot of info. All righty. So that's our reveals for the day. That was a lot of reveals, a lot of pre-orders. But as always, Pulse is not just about product or product reveals. And stay tuned. Tune into Pulse Unboxed because we have some great stories that just went up in recent weeks, including a new toy timeline on our hot snow speeders throughout the years, culminating in our recent Black Series 6-inch snowspeeder. And then we also had a story talking about how we've decided to celebrate our 40th anniversaries with our Black Series 40th anniversary assortments. So check them out and let us know in the comments what other Pulse Unboxed content you'd like to read about.
And these live streams are great, but this isn't the end of the reveals. So each year we do an exclusive that starts off in the EU and then comes to the US afterwards. And last year it was the Black Series Skywalker Strikes Pack. So guys, stay tuned to the news of the EU next week because they'll be revealing this year's EU exclusive.
Fantastic. All right. Now, possibly most importantly, a small quick update on our HasLab project. Now, we revealed in June that there would be, I know, so exciting. We revealed that there would be a HasLab project, that it would be coming sometime in 2020, and that it would be Vintage Collection. Well, we're letting you know today that it will be launching in September. In a few weeks, sometime in September, we will be back with a live stream to launch that campaign. So keep the guesses coming. We love reading the speculation, and we will be kicking off that campaign in a few weeks. So you don't have to worry about it coming in October, November, December. The wait will be over soon. We are so excited. Are you excited, Emily?
Oh my gosh, guys. We're so hyped for this project, and we just can't wait to reveal it.
Fantastic.
All right. So let's get on to the Q&A. So some of you guys have submitted questions and comments, and we're going to answer some of them right now. And as always, we're happy to answer difficult questions, but we won't be answering anything that isn't constructive. So let's go on to the questions. Okay, so we got a question here. What can fans expect to see from the Vintage Collection in 2021? Well, we can't comment on anything that we haven't revealed yet publicly, but we always try to support and highlight the latest and most relevant entertainments. And right now, fans really love The Mandalorian and The Clone Wars, so we're exploring what potential figures could look like in that line. Additionally, we continue to love the enthusiasm for the vintage original 96, so we'll continue trying to get more of those Kenner figures onto a vintage card back for the first time. And there's always more exciting things in the works, so just keep tuning in for reveals.
All righty. Our next question, you can see it on the screen. Why are there so many re-releases within the Black Series line? So it's a good question, and I'm sure, you know, vintage fans might have the same question as well. As It's interesting. In the Black Series line, I think it was 2017 that we first started doing re-releases. Obviously, with our 40th anniversary lines, we've done them and then in the archive. And it's interesting. With the archive, you know, we kind of talked about with that line, the strategy was that there were a lot of fans that hadn't gotten in on the Black Series originally and then wanted a chance. They had bought some of the more recent figures, but they hadn't had a chance to get in on some of those older figures. Some of the aftermarket values were higher, and so we wanted a way for them to get into the line. And there was, when we revealed the arc, was kind of the strategy, and fans have reacted positively to that. It's proved very popular with fans. And so that was kind of the rationale behind that greatest hits line, highlighting those greatest hits characters. And kind of we've seen that same reaction to the 40th anniversary lines. And, you know, especially with the 40th anniversary lines, like putting those figures on that classic card back, like it's just been such a great marriage. And, you know I love my, you know, normal Black Series figures. You know, there's obviously this modern aesthetic is so great, but it's also great seeing those Black Series figures on that classic card back. And it certainly doesn't take away from the new figures that we do. It's kind of purely a bonus to the line. So hopefully that helps clear that up a bit.
Okay, next up. Star Wars toy fans are passionate about setting up displays with figures, but it's very difficult to army build with the Black Series and the Vintage Collection. Is there any consideration to introduce army building figures like stormtroopers or battle droids? Yeah, thanks for this question. So definitely troop building has often been in our discussions for the future of the line. And for Vintage Collection and the Black Series, we've definitely been looking to bring more troopers and army units into our mainline character selections. Now, for us, a stormtrooper has a lot of deco actually needed for accuracy to the costume, and that includes sort of those breaks in the armor. Those areas are actually pretty detailed. So for us, we've continued to prioritize accuracy to the detail of those troopers. And our main goal has continued to be just doing justice to the awesome intricacies of the Star Wars galaxy and keeping those stormtroopers in the mainline price.
Fantastic. All right, next question. Can you tell us more about the figure selection process and how you choose which characters will be made into the line? It's a great question. So it's honestly, there's a strong partnership here. So obviously, you know, Hasbro, we certainly talk amongst ourselves and we have some conversations, but you know, it's an open conversation and it's a strong partnership and collaboration with Lucasfilm. You know, we work closely with Lucasfilm, you know, and we trust their insights and their wisdom. Obviously, you know, Star Wars is, we think it's, you know, the best brand in the business, obviously, and they've created it and nurtured it over, you know, the past 40 some years. And so, you know, we certainly, you know, Hasbro has a long history as well in the toy business, especially action figures. And so we bring that, but obviously, you know, we fully respect the insights and wisdom that Lucasfilms brings in terms of the Star Wars brand. So we work closely in terms of which characters we feel would resonate best with fans and collectors. And certainly we feel like Lucasfilm kind of has that, you know, same respect for the insights that we bring. You know, I feel that our designers are amazing. I mean, you know, Emily here trained with Mark Boudreau, who's a, you know, a legend within the toy industry. So, you know, I think at the end of the day, kind of both Hasbro and Lucasfilm respect the years of knowledge and insight that we bring to the table. And kind of each decision is made with the utmost attention to detail that we know that fans and collectors will appreciate. So it really is collaborative. It's made with the fans in mind, honestly. And hopefully some of the reveals you've seen here today reflect that. And you know, hopefully the line is continuing to deliver what you're looking for in the figures.
All right. So will there be more playsets coming out within the Black Series and the Vintage Collection? Fans really want to see a Sarlacc pit or Rancor chamber. That's a cool one. So the Star Wars galaxy is filled with amazing planets and locations. And yeah, we really enjoyed bringing these environments to life through playsets. The scale of the Vintage Collection is just naturally made for world building and diorama shelf displays, like my cool little one over here. So we're always exploring ways to just continue to develop those fan favorite locations. And we're continuing to think about these for sure. And for our Black Series figures, the team is like thinking about ways to bring smaller scenes into the line that might be appropriate for the 6-inch scale. So for sure, look out for us to keep building out more and more of the Star Wars world.
All righty. And our final question, what is the possibility that Black Series fans could see accessory bundles or assorted weapons packs that may never have been released originally with the figures. The example given is Rey's yellow lightsaber. So again, it's a good question. We like to compliment all the questions submitted. It's something we often talk about. Obviously, you know, we will sometimes release a figure, and then an accessory like that is available later. And it's a great accessory. Obviously, kind of Rey's yellow lightsaber at the end of Rise of Skywalker was amazing. And it's kind of this struggle of how to get it out. And, you know, I remember, the mouse droid from episode 4, like we ended up, you know, that went out with Tarkin because we wanted to get it out there. And so it's funny, there's kind of these small accessories, but it is kind of that discussion of how to get it out there. So, yeah, you know, accessory bundles are something we've definitely discussed. Finding the right way to integrate those accessory packs into releases isn't, you know, it's a challenge, including them with figures is obviously kind of the standard way to do it, but it has to make sense. So we're always just exploring new ways to provide the line with those appropriate bundles that do the figures justice and make sense. But it's definitely something we've discussed. It could make sense for the line if we can kind of figure out how to do it. And it's definitely something we've discussed. But obviously, kind of getting the accessories with the figures is the normal way we go. Those are the questions. Those are the reveals. It's our August live stream. So exciting. Thank you all for joining us. Again, thanks for coming over from whatever live stream you were channel surfing on before. We love being here. We love doing these. Hopefully you enjoyed it. September, it's going to be a HasLab launch. We're so excited. So wherever you're channel surfing in September, come on over in September, and we will be there for a HasLab launch. So have a great day. I'm going to go back, under the table where I apparently was before. So love you all. Have a great day. We'll see you again soon.
Thanks, everyone. Get hyped for HasLab. Ha ha ha.